clothes allowed, but never square.
The King's Road at World's End has traditionally been a mecca for trendsetters in the world of fashion and art, a magnet for up-and-coming designers, pop stars and young trendies, those not interested in the tried and tested. But the swinging 60s have well and truly turned into the commercial 80s, and smaller shop owners say they're being priced out of the market by landlords rising their rents by thousands of pounds.
When I moved in, my rent was £7,500. I'm now faced 4 years later with a 200% increase on my rent, which I feel for a half shop is completely unjustified.
The only people who are going to lose out besides ourselves are the community and the customers. King's Road is important to England's tourist industry. Everyone knows the King's Road, rather like Carnaby Street in the 60s. It cannot be allowed to slip into oblivion and another Oxford Street with empty shops, overpriced rents and overpriced clothing.
It's a view endorsed by many local shoppers and tourists.
Can't be done, man, I'm busy. Shopping to do.
We're from New York and we've always heard about all the fashion shops and things like that on King's Road.
So why are you here?
To buy some clothes. Some clothes that hopefully are out of the ordinary, not your usual next garb.
So will the chain stores muscle in as many fear? Property negotiator Charles Varra says not. He thinks there are enough small retailers willing to pay the higher price for a King's Road address.
I've recently let two shops in this part of the King's Road where we had five or six retailers for each bidding competitively at the same levels of rent, of different styles, of different trading backgrounds and ideas. And so from that point of view, there is clearly a market that says they can afford to take premises in this part of the King's Road.
That's little comfort to fashion designers who have made King's Road their business base. But they have pledged they won't leave the trendiest street in town without a fight. This is Selka Tullett for Thames News.